What's up, everyone? Welcome back. If you're new here, welcome. I'm Chris. And yeah, Chris is on the Hot Mess Express today. It's been a long day, and I know I look like a mess, but it's okay. It's okay. I'm good with it. All right. And I'm really tired, so I hope this video comes out okay. We'll see. Anyway, what I wanted to share was a de-stash that I did. And I'm so excited about it. Yeah. So I haven't smelled anything yet, but I did open it. Why did I open it up? I don't remember. There was a reason I opened it up. I don't know if it was raining that day and the box got wet. I don't remember. But I opened it. But I haven't smelled anything yet. Some of the stuff, obviously, I knew what it smells like because I bought it. But she was kind enough, Amanda Hamilton, and she, of course, threw in extras here, and I can't wait to smell them because they're things that I've never smelled before. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so we're going to start with this one first because this was so ironic because I just finished my tub, and lo and behold, I got another one. It's Speakeasy from Teddy B's. I love this scent. Speakeasy is fire roasted marshmallows, soft wood, sandalwood, hints of floral coconut, and Palo Santo. It's gorgeous. Oh, yeah. Absolutely love, love, love it. Love, love, love. Okay. I can't say enough about it. It smells so good. So good. And I'm so happy that I was able to snag another tub of it. Because as I melted the rest of last of mine, I was like, oh, I got to request, see if Teddy B's will pour this one again because it's so beautiful and I want more. And then I saw Amanda was selling it and I'm like, I'll buy it. Me, me, me. Okay. This next one is Sugar Spice and Fireside, and I am pretty sure I do not have this in my collection. I don't think I do. I gotta check my spreadsheet, but I grabbed this, and this is the smell of snickerdoodles and oatmeal cookies baking in a wood fire oven. I don't think I have this one. So, and this is all ready to go because this is from October of last year. So pretty. Oh, this is good. You definitely get the cinnamony cookies, and you get the hint of a wood fire oven, like that, not an oven, but you get a woody note here. And the oatmeal. Oh, this is beautiful. Yes. Okay. Then this one I did not have. Oh, yes. See, I never had this. Oh, and I love it. It's already cut for me. This is apple caramel streusel cake. Never had it. And it's all nice and cured because this is from 22. This is cinnamon spice cake, vanilla icing, brown sugar, and crisp apples with a light drizzle of caramel. Let's see. Thanks, Amanda. I'm glad it's already chopped. Amanda is awesome. Love her. She needs a YouTube channel because she hides in the shadows and buys all this wax. And I want to see what she buys. Okay, to my nose, what this smells like, I don't get cake. I get the icy note, I get apples, and I get cinnamon. Mmm. It's sweet. I'm spilling it. This is going to be absolutely beautiful for October. This just has October vibes to it. The cinnamon and the apples and the sweetness. Yeah, can't wait. Another one that I've never smelled. It is a Queen of the South. Queen of the South is sponge sugar, cashmere musk, wildflower honey, white peach nectar, and sweet mandarin. And this is from last July, so I could actually warm this right now. Ooh, very musky. You get a lot of musk. I'm getting the sweetness from the peach. And definitely the mandarin. So this is like a sweet, lightly floral musk. This is pretty. Bedroom, bathroom, absolutely. In fact, I think I'm going to do it tomorrow. Because I can't wait. I want to smell it. That's pretty. Then I also wanted to try this blend because I never tried it. Again, going a little out of my wheelhouse here with trying different things. This is Beach Treats Brown Sugar and Fig and Tahitian Vanilla. This is from last March. And it's called Oasis. So, first off, I love her beach treats. So, just add brown sugar to beach treats and fig and Tahitian vanilla. Oh, that's nice. So, you definitely get her beach treats blend. The fresh oceanic air, the sea salt. Marshmallows, but then you get a little bit of sweetness here from the fig in that brown sugar, and the vanilla just makes it even more creamy like. Pretty, very pretty. Another one I could actually start melting right now. Might as well. Okay. Oh. Ha. Okay. Two more. Fiji. I was curious about it. I thought, you know what? I want to smell it. This is from 22. This is sea salt, driftwood, green clover, and aloe, and warm vanilla sugar. I don't know. I want to try it. And you know what? Sometimes D-Stashes is the best place to try scents because they're already cured. I like this. I do. This is very summery. And I struggle to find a lot of scents that I like for summer. And this is kind of why I wanted to try this one. Because I wanted to see what I may like going forward. Oh, I definitely get the sea salt here. That is there. And I love that. There is floral here, but it's, I'm picking up a, like a very soft floral. Possibly that's the green clover. 100% driftwood. I happen to find that I've become a big fan of driftwood. I do like that in blends. Warm vanilla sugar. I don't know if I smell that so much. This just smells like a really fresh, clean, not laundry, a fresh, clean scent. It's a, you know, the notes are clean, they're crisp, and it's airy. I'm gonna melt this. This is also getting melted right away because I want to try it. Okay, you guys, you know, when you want to know so badly what a scent smells like and you can't get your hands on it, well, I got my hands on it. And I'm glad, because if I see it, if I love this and I see it in a pre-order, I know I can grab it without being scared. So I was able to get this in the D-Stash, and that is Petrichor. The infamous dirt. This is the scent of wet earth after the rain. This was poured 2/2023, so it's ready to go now. So, before I open it, there's been a lot of talk. You either love this or you hate it and think it's disgusting. My nose is starting to really love earthy more and more and more. So I'm thinking, what if I want to make a blend, just become a little more earthy? I could use this to mix it if this is like something that you don't want to melt on your own. But let's see. I'm scared, you guys. Okay. It's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. You guys, I kind of like this. I do. There's almost a sweetness to it. I don't even know what to say. It smells like dirt. It does. But it doesn't smell like dirty dirt. This is like if you had a bag of potting soil and your potting flowers were a plant. That's what it smells like, but there's just a touch of a sweet, pretty note here. So it's like, it's dirt, but it's not, again, it's not dirty dirt. Look at me. Don't I look like Howdy Doody? You know, he starts singing, it's Howdy Doody time. This is gonna drive me crazy. Anyway, I swear to God, I have ADD. I have not been diagnosed, but I do that. I just, squirrel. Dirt. This is like fancy dirt. I can't explain it. I kind of want to give the same reaction that I gave when I smelled Sassy Girl Aromas Petrichor. I was like, oh my God. I says, I love it. It smells like rich people's dirt. This is like rich people dirt. It's not like, I don't know. There's something about it. I'm going to try it because there's something about this that I like. And I, it's weird. It's really weird. It's one of those smells. It's like, you just gotta keep smelling it because it's interesting. It's like, what? Okay. I'm gonna try it on its own first. If it's not what I want as a single note, this is definitely something beautiful to throw in when you're doing an outdoorsy blend that's blended with a little more something. Things with it, you want to just give it a little bit more of an earthy feel, this would work. I am like super happy with this. Amanda, you sold it, so tell me more. What didn't you like? Did you not like the Petrichor? Because I'm just curious. Okay, so she threw in some extras here. And so grateful because I have very little of this vendor. And what I do have, I really, really like. And what I have melted, I've gotten really, really good results from. And it's Super Tarts. So she threw in some random Super Tarts, thinking maybe might be something I'm into. This one's called Fresh Start. And Fresh Start is cucumber, cactus, sea salt, and fresh cut grass. I think I will like this. First of all, I like cucumber. I love sea salt. And cactus is beautiful too. They are just nice, refreshing scents for the home when, you know, you just want something that's not so complicated and complex. And I'm kind of liking fresh cut grass now too. Yes, I like this. This is very, it's just a fresh scent. It's just a clean scent. And I don't mean clean like laundry clean. And I got to take this phone call, but I will be back in 2 shakes of a lamb's tail. Tell me what movie that's from while I'm gone. All right, so that's that. I also turned my air conditioning up while I was taking that little break because it's getting hot in here. Or it's just me. I don't know. But anyway, let's talk, get back to talking about this Fresh Start. I like this. It's, you definitely get the cucumber scent there. And I happen to like cucumber fragrance. It's watery. And I like that. The sea salt in here is nice. The, you get a little bit of the green note from the cactus. And definitely you get the fresh cut grass. This is a beautiful springtime and summertime scent. You know, these came at the perfect time because they're cured, they're ready to go, and I can melt them right away and see if I like them on warm. Yeah, I'm really excited. Thank you so much for including that in my de-stash because, again, it just gives me that chance to smell. Okay, the next one is Great White. And I 100% positive I am going to fall in love with this because this is Jaws. Jaws from Super Tarts is sea salt, ozone, seagrass, plum, pear. And she added white tea. You know, I love white tea. So, and I love Super Tarts Jaws. That I did buy. Oh, this is fantastic. And what I really like the most about this is I'm getting all the Jaws blend here and the white tea, because white tea is a super strong note and it's not, it's subtle in here. This is pretty. You do, you just get that ozone, that sea salt, the plum is adding a little bit of the sweetness with the pear, and then you get the hint of the white tea. Beautiful. Beautiful. I got a lot to melt here. This is gonna be my melting right here out of this de-stash this week. Probably not the caramel apple. No, that's definitely going to be in the fall. Probably the sugar and spice too and speakeasy. I just finished that, so I'm just going to wait on that one. But these fresh scents, I'm going to do now. All right, the next one here is called Whale Song. Whale Song is Jaws and Blue Sugar. And scent notes for that, again, are sea salt, ozone, seagrass, pear, plum, and blue sugar. Oh, that blue sugar adds a nice touch to this. So you get that fresh, beachy air vibe from the Jaws blend here. But the blue sugar adds just a hint of a cologne note to it. That's pretty. I don't know what I want to melt first. Jeez Louise. Only so many days in the week and only so many warmers. Okay, and last but not least, I'm really curious about this one. It's called Blown Up. Again, this is her Jaws blend, sea salt, ozone, seagrass, plum, pear, and lemon custard. So, okay, oh, that's interesting. Okay, this might come off, I gotta warm it again. I gotta warm it, but this might have a little bit of a pledge note here. Not that that's always a bad thing, because you know what? When you've cleaned your house, you know, and you've dusted your furniture and stuff, and you put a little polish on it, it kind of smells nice, right? It smells like, oh, you just cleaned. Yeah. I'm trying to think, what am I doing this week? Oh, I got my grandson. Not that that's a bad thing. I think because I finally got my bedroom set, I don't know which video I mentioned that in, but yes, I did buy a bedroom set. When I demolished my bedroom here and clean it top to bottom, get paint going, I think I'm going to throw this in the warmers in the bedroom. Okay. It's nice. I do like it. I'm feeling more clean vibes with this one. All right, you guys. So that was my de-stash that I did with Amanda. If you happen to see her post for, you know, de-stash, jump in on it. She's good. She's packages things very well. She ships on time. And yeah, very reputable. So you could trust her. And yeah, that's all I got. Thank you so much, Amanda. I'm so glad that I was able to make these purchases, and I so appreciate you throwing in those extras for me. That was very nice. And I'm excited to try those like right away, actually, because, you know, I'm not very, don't have a lot of super tarts, and I'm excited to try new and different things from her. All right, everybody. Thank you for watching. I appreciate you. I appreciate the time you take out of your day, your lives, your busy schedules, and you watch a video I've uploaded, because that really means a lot to me. It makes me feel like I'm not doing this all for nothing, that I'm able to share and people really like it and enjoy it. So it means a lot. Yeah, please comment, like, and subscribe. That helps boost my algorithms on YouTube, gets my videos out there seen to more people, and yeah, so because I'm trying to get my channel to grow, and yeah. Why I always have a hard time closing these videos out. Have a great day, great night, great week, whenever you have to be watching, and we will chat again real soon. Bye.